Good evening, ladies as well as gentlemen. Papa Boris here with some more Armello. Step into luxury. Anyway, we've played with four of the characters, one from each clan. It was pointed out to me that I actually picked the woman of the clan each time. Didn't even notice that. Totally coincidental. We're gonna go back around through and do the dudes. The first video I did was with River. Let's go ahead and do the male counterpart here. Thane, the Swordmaster. Honestly, one of the more lame characters, I think, in the game. So, big fight. Reasonably healthy, kind of crappy wizard and wits and spirit. And his ability, sword cards burned pierce defenses. Honestly, this seems more like a special ability on the level of like a ring rather than like an actual character power. It just doesn't really seem that great. But he's a very straightforward character. You probably want to beef up your wits at least once, either by getting the stat at the beginning or by doing a wits quest. And then you pretty much want to do your quests and kill the king. That's the way to go for this guy, so I'm not going to be the most groundbreaking gameplay here, but that is what we'll do. I don't like the wolf starting ring, stealth and mountains, eh. I'm going to take the second one, get +1 magic anytime you kill somebody. The next ring is probably better, get 1 gold anytime you kill somebody as opposed to magic. Know that this has to be battle, so like blasting people with spells and throwing axes does not give you this bonus magic. The wolf final ring, by the way, which you have to play 10 games with the wolves to unlock. That's crazy. That's definitely what I would play with every single goddamn time, no matter what my strategy was or who I was playing against. Because getting to move through mountains for one action point is ridiculous. But anyway, for now, we'll just have settled with this. And I'm going to challenge myself in the second series of games. I'm not going to commit to doing it for all the characters, but for this one at least, I'm not going to pick one of the stat amulets. I feel like those are just the best ones. We're going to go ahead and grab Watch. This is the one that you unlock for getting a Kingslayer victory, so it makes it easier to break into the castle. And if you're going on, you know, your quests, you sometimes have to walk through perils. This helps you not get screwed over by them, especially because your wits suck. We're up against, right, we're up against River, and so it's the wolves versus the bears, Day Clan versus Night Clan. Everybody's kind of poor. Nobody here actually starts with too much money. I think Thane starts with the most of these four characters. The rats and the rabbits are a little bit richer. So, what we're going for, obviously, is trying to get some good items. I'm going to be drawing pretty much exclusively from the item deck initially. And I also eventually want to up my body and my wits. So, let's see. The Lionheart Breastplate is a really great item. This thing is fantastic. But I don't want to get my spirit just yet. Spirit Stone, I'd have a 50-50 chance of getting this thing, but I'd rather just honestly get my wits up. Now this guy is a really, really good one. Only a 30% chance of getting him unless I'm lucky enough to pull a Evil Eye spell, which I'm probably not going to be even trying for. But yeah, whatever, I'll take the 30% odds, and the +1 to wits is more important. If the negative effect of this quest is really bad, like the negative effect of failure, I will just ignore it and take the +1 body. This is actually really far away. Holy shit, that's the farthest away I've ever had an opening quest. Wow, it's gonna take me 3 turns to get there. 1, 2, 3. Yeah, I can't get in there. Wow. So do I take this settlement? 1, 2, 3. I still get there in 3 turns. So it's either taking this settlement and risking a peril or going through a dungeon and then having pretty much nothing else until I get there. Jeez, that sucks. So, settlement, it'll be +1 gold 2 turns from now. I'd rather just get a bunch of gold up front from this dungeon, honestly. Of course, with the dungeon, I might not get gold. I might have a bane or something. But no, we got gold. 2 gold. So, it's kind of like as good as this 3 turns from now. I think that was a pretty fair trade. What do we got? Bullshit. Bullshit. And, bullshit. Okay, great. That's awesome. I could have a very small chance of actually killing someone with that. Don't want to cast this on myself right now? I definitely do. Because I'm going to recharge up to 3 mana at night anyhow. God, this thing's so bad. Alright, well, we'll just burn that in battle. It is the wild symbol, so it explodes. Note that Thane's ability, as if it wasn't bad enough already, it only works on swords, not on other hits, so suns or moons or wild symbols. Alright, he got teleported, which didn't work out too bad for him, although it might be far away from his quest. Wow, lots of perils in crappy places. See if River can make hers. She can. She avoids losing an action point and 2 health, so that was pretty lucky for her. I've got Sana in the game. She's a real pushover. Her starting stat appears to be she chose to get plus one fight. Let's actually take a look at all of their choices. It seems to be done totally at random. So what did he get? Did I ask to go away from that? Damn it. All right. So he got grow, which works pretty well with his high health. Plus one wits is a pretty good choice, and plus one fight. That's one way to play Sana, is try to overcome her terrible, terrible low fight stat. Although, as I showed off in my video on her, my personal preference is actually just to, you know, embrace the bad fight and focus on other things. I'm gonna keep going for items. We gotta get something good. Oh, bullshit. Terrible. Well, can't get anything at all. All right. Well, we do get a spirit stone, because it's right there. And I needed to go through here anyway to get my magic. Christ, do I put this on? The problem is, if I ever fight anybody in a forest, I will be evading, which just sucks. What is this? Play to four mountain forest plains. I can actually give Sana. Wait, isn't that a plains? What is this? Play to. Oh, dungeon forest mountains. I see these guys. I hate wasting two gold just to get this out of my hand. You know, I'm not gonna do it. I'm not gonna waste two gold just to throw that out of my hand. So do I waste two gold to have evade in forest, which I do not want, just so I can draw more cards? No. I don't have any settlements, so while I have a lot of gold right now, my income is just one every dawn, so I really don't need to waste my money. All right, Sana actually can deal some damage to this guy, and he beats the living butts out of her. Bryn's abilities, he gets plus one fight for every spell he casts until the end of the next battle. So if you want to just, you know, do a bunch of spells and then kill somebody. Wow, what the hell? Oh, how much health does this guy have? Jesus, I hope that's a buff that wears off right now. Nope. River, you gonna fight him for me? Oh, balls. He's in my quest. That stupid teleportation really messed me up. Well, we're going for it. We got three cards to burn here in this fight. I just have to hope I do enough damage to push him out of the way. I don't care about killing him. I just want to deal more damage to him than he deals to me, so that I get my quest and take over that settlement. Man, why are we all here? I don't understand why we're all ending up over here. Oh, brother. Okay. So we lose two gold. That actually kind of sucks because I can't really afford to lose gold. I would have honestly rather lost the prestige if I had a choice. Jesus. I could put on this cloak and then I'd have stealth in my fight against him, which would prevent him from burning his cards. How many cards is he holding? Can you see that? Can you see how many cards someone has? And he's got the day affinity and I'm knight. Christ. All right. Yeah, we'll put this on. Don't want to, but yeah. Let's go fight him. So he can't burn cards. At least he's just relying on the dice and his plus one sword from this item, which is more than I could get. All right, well, let's pop some mountain moss in there and this hidden trap and roll three dice. So I got some good hits in here. Roll two shields, which is really good. So that's lucky. So I don't take as much damage. I would have actually been down at one health if I hadn't gotten those lucky shield rolls. I don't care about killing him. Oh, he's actually routed because he has no place to retreat. What a clusterfuck. Jesus. So I actually get a prestige for this because I did kill him, right? Did I not? Why don't I get a prestige for killing him? Well, whatever. Minus three gold. Shoot. Oh, God. I can't afford that. I mean, the blacksmith is great. He gives you tons of bonus shields and swords. But, Matt, you just, I just couldn't lose three gold there. I would have totally taken, like, a prestige hit or something. Look at this nine magic I have. That's so great. Christ. All right, that's not good. Wildfire staff's kind of interesting. It's free. It's not a good one, but it's free. I can go for a spirit stone. You know, let's just get the body here. Try for the staff. It is tempting to go for those spirit stones, you know, just because I already have one. But the staff is pretty good. It gives me some more magic and some more spirit, which can help me a bit more, be a bit more well-rounded. And the spirit stones are just totally worthless if I don't end up getting the victory. I feel like I had a pretty slow start here, and I'm not drawing any items. Man, Sana's just getting whooped. Oh man, it's just getting tickled to death. Is River really gonna follow through and get this final kill? Yep. So River did 3 damage with her passive to this poor bear. Well, glad I wasn't on the receiving end of that, because she could have killed me. I mean, I would have done better in the fights, I think. Just because I'm throwing more dice. All right, Sana, come on. Payback. Payback. Aw, Sana. Gotta stand up for yourself, girl. All right. Gotta remember, I have evade in forest, so if I step into a forest, does that mean that I'll be evading? And I won't be able to fight the person? I actually don't know how that works. If I fight someone in a forest? Yeah, I think if I'm in a forest, then that's how that works. Oh, the guard died. So I could actually fight a Bane, try to get a prestige here. This Bane does have 4 health. And rolling 5 dice. Alright, I need an item! For God's sake! Give me something good. No! Oh my god! Come on! Oh, for fuck's sake. Alright, we're gonna draw a spell just to have something to— Oh, of course! It's the thing that's rotting! So if I cast this on myself, I could actually, I don't have any... I could actually, get 2 rot and start going for a rot victory. Do I want to do that? This doesn't cure rot, it's just temporary. These are just, like, the worst items. Wow. I don't think I want to go for this plague business. That doesn't seem smart. I hate just wandering back over here. Oh, man. Should I take the long way around? I'm gonna just take the long way around to that quest. Let's fight this Bane. Gotta get my prestige. And burn up all my shitty cards. Alright, so we're at night at least, so I do get an extra die. Let's get rid of this moss for sure. And then the sap. Do I feel confident enough to just throw away this plague card? No, I need to roll my dice. The more shields I get, the better. Oh, that was a pretty hard hit there. Well, I did kill the Bane. Oh, and I died. Oops. Okay. Well. Gives me a rot. Which isn't the best thing. It does put me next to my quest, though. Alright, screw it. The question is, do I cast rot on myself? In order to get the extra rot, and then I have to also suffer poison. I try casting it on someone else. Settlement or swamp? Well, my options are kind of limited here. I only have a range of 3, and it has to play it on a swamp. I mean, I could just play it somewhere and just not hit a person with it. Alright, what's River doing here? Getting lucky on those perils. Been hiding in the forest. So I can go into the settlement and plague myself, then I'll be poisoned the following round, but I do have wild weed to heal up some of that damage. Alright, we're going for it. I'm up to 3 rot already. Just gonna have to friggin' go for it. And then I'm gonna get +1 body from the quest, so maybe I'll be able to... Now that I'm going for rot, I would have rather gotten more wit so I could draw more cards, but... Yeah, we're gonna change gears a little bit here. Hope I get some rot-granting items like Poison Gift or Marauder Gauntlets. The key is to get up to 5, and then I can start killing Banes. Did I keep that settlement? Did I keep a hold of it? I did, so at least I get 2 gold during the day. Still looking for my first item, and of course I don't know what this peril is. Ugh, okay. Well, still want items. Spells are cute and all. Oh man, I have all this magic that I'm wasting. Let's do 1 of each. Ah, terrible. It's only a defensive item. Mirror Image is decent, so I'll cast it, because otherwise I'm just wasting the magic. I cannot plague a forest. Only settlements or swamps. Nobody's in one. Well, let's see what this peril is before I make any commitments. Target is exiled the nearest unoccupied mountain. You've got to be kidding me. Alright, I'm gonna burn this spear and just hope I roll a shield, because I think this would stop me from finishing my quest. Oh my god, I got very lucky there rolling a shield, so I don't get exiled to a mountain. Minus one prestige, I'll take that chance. I don't really care about prestige at this point. And if I get the staff, that would be so close. It was down to three and whatever. It's all the same. So I could just do it. You know, we're going for it. So I'm poisoned. I think that carries through the end of my next turn. Let's see here. I'm gonna take a step forward. And then I'm gonna have some wild weed. I don't mind getting attacked by Brun because I do have mirror image here, so he'll lose two dice. He really doesn't want to fight me right now. I don't have any options to improve my rot, unfortunately. Throwing axe! Oh, you bitch! Oh well, I shouldn't complain. I mean, the AI really doesn't use those sorts of effects as much as they ought to. Alright, so he's got the bonus for the day. He's got that sword. Man, I'd kill for that sword. Oh man, I got so many misses. Jesus! You gotta be kidding me! Oh man! At least I could have killed this guy if I had, like, actually landed some hits, but that was just a crazy amount of misses. So instead of us both killing each other, he just straight up kills me. And then he takes over my settlement. Asshole. Okay. I'm likely to be far away from my quest. Well, Spirit Stone, that's not happening. Do I get more spirit? Just to be able to cast more of the spells I draw? No, let's go ahead and, while equipped, draw is considered zero. That's terrible. I don't want that. Oh, God. So five wits and three spirit, or four of each. I'm gonna go for this because I'm still gonna be drawing items. I do need to get some combat items at some point. So it'd be nice to be able to draw more cards. Christ, I'm a cracker. Did Brun not take over my settlement? Where did he go? Oh, he went over here. I guess he's going for his quest. All right, well, I guess, oh man, dying got rid of my poison. That's perfect. I guess we can go to this circle. And then there's like no dungeons on the way over here. But if I go the other way, it's like a cluster and everyone's over here. So I could go for the Spirit Stone, but the problem is, well, River can get it before me, and the other problem is you don't want to go for Rotten Spirit Stones at the same time, because once you get corrupted, you can't go into the circles anymore. Terrible. Awful. You've got to be fucking kidding me. Oh, Jesus. I cannot draw a single good card to save my life. This is really remarkable. All right, we're gonna pause by this dungeon on my way to the quest. I wanna get some stuff. A spirit stone. Oh, God. Well, I could just let's go into this forest. Maybe River won't want this thing. Who the hell knows, right? Longbow is such a terrible item, and it's expensive too. Hey, maybe I could put the Wall of Thorns here. Oh, pro plays all day. So I guard that off until dawn, making sure I get the Spirit Stone, and we're going for Spirit Stones. I wish I'd picked the quest that gives a Spirit Stone. As it is, I'm gonna have to get lucky with like getting a crystallized and somehow getting six mana to use it, or maybe like just dealing with having three rot. The problem is having rot is so bad because if you have rot and you fight the king gets three bonus dice, which is obviously not ideal. So we'll just hope these spirit stones work out. Maybe I find another one near me somewhere. Who the hell knows? Can I kill Brun? Oh man, Brun, you are so gonna fucking die. Oh man, I'm gonna burn this longbow in battle. So long as I do that, I'm guaranteed the kill. He does have a lot of fight. Is that permanent? Does he actually have that much fight? He has six fight. Wow, that's a lot of dice. Maybe it's better just to throw an axe at him. Yeah, I should probably throw an axe at him. That's probably the smarter play by a mile. Because letting him throw that many dice increases my risk of dying. I don't have any defensive items or anything. Cannot draw a good card to save my life. All right, he's got a lot of prestige. I definitely want to kill him. Bring him down a peg. King orders his guards to march to their nearest settlement and terrorize him, which is kind of good. Makes it so that if you take over that settlement later, you get a prestige for doing it. I might have to try to get some prestige as a backup, because it's looking pretty rough here. Oh, he's going to take over my settlement. Ass wagon. Yeah, I'm only, like, what, on my third quest? So I still have to do one more quest before I can get entry into the palace. Alright, that settlement I can take over maybe sometime. Alright, I have no magic, so no point drawing spells. I don't want to use Moon Juice. There's a good card. Finally. It's not even that good. It's just better than nothing. Okay, do I chuck a throwing axe at him? Honestly, I don't want to because I don't have any income right now. But I don't want him to throw six dice against me either. Then again, I could use up this longbow if I attacked him. Of course, I'm using up the axe. Yeah, let's just play it safe. Just kill him. I get a prestige. He loses a prestige. Let's go to the forest here. And sure, let's go here. Maybe I'll get like some kind of a story. Sometimes you get a story for walking in those places. Nope. I still can go for rot, so I have three spirit stones, but I'm keeping my options open. If I do get something that lets me get two rot for one card, then, you know, it'd be worth it to get the rot, get up to five, then I can start killing Banes and hope for a rot victory. Kingsguard, oh, he's not gonna move away. I'd have to actually fight him out of his space in order to get over that settlement. Well, I've got a bounty on my head, so I guess I might as well do that anyway. If I'm gonna have a bounty regardless, makes sense to go over here, get a prestige for having the settlement. A Bane popped up here. River's gonna try her luck. No, the Bane's attacking River. River is evading. Why is River evading? That doesn't give her evade. Don't actually know what made her evade. Unless she cast a spell on herself. I wish that the thing that popped up on the side showed you what it was. How come she wasn't evading here? It's weird. Alright, anyway. Sana's just been killed. I could try to beat up on Thane, depending on where she ends her turn. No, I really want to go for this guard. Take over that settlement. Yeah, if I had that ring that makes mountains not have a penalty, I could just go attack Thane in the dungeon. Wouldn't be bad, huh? Alright, it's good that it's night, so I get a +1 die against that guard for being a member of the Knight Clan. There's a Spirit Stone. Oh my god. Oh, good talking, Boris. Oh my god. There's nobody over here. I can totally get this Spirit Stone. It'll take me a couple of turns. I'd have to walk like this through the swamp, heal, and go over. There's no point walking through both of these swamps. Right, not bad. So these spirit stones just spawn in all the right places. Yeah, we're going for a spirit stone victory. So at that point, it sucks that I got all this rot. But the good news is I have kind of a flexible array of options. I could try to break through the castle by getting some cards maybe that let me, you know, give me an advantage on perils. I do have a one automatic success, right? Because I have this guaranteed first symbol match on perils. Is that why I got lucky and rolled the shield? Is that how they implemented it? That it just rolls the right number? Grant Scout. Thanks, game. That's exactly what I needed. Should I get a spell? Let's try to get a spell. Why not? All cards in hand change the rot symbols. All right, well, might as well get four rot. Why not? Wait, oh, unless I can't reach anybody. I don't want to give myself rot symbols because that's bad. Thane, where are you? Oh, you disappeared. Damn. Well, I guess I can hold on to that for a turn. It sucks that I don't use it up right now. I mean, I could do it on myself, I guess. Hey! Okay, so, crap. I forget what all this stuff does. These are all very predictable things. I totally forget. I think the scythe gives you like some like a bane weapon where it gives you bonus dice and you get damage and it costs a rot to equip it. Salvation, I think, I don't remember. Crap. You know what? I'm gonna just stone cold cheat right now. I'm looking it up. Armello, stone. Hopefully it's gonna find it. Nope, that didn't do it. Let's try searching for scythe. Maybe, like, that would, you know, tell me about the quest. Yep, this is the lamest thing I've ever done. Oh, moon scythe is a treasure card. God darn it, that's so not... Okay, let's see. Stone. What's the other thing called? Salvation. And, scythe. Okay, come on, Google. Find it for me. Stone, Salvation, Scythe. Okay, Stone, Salvation, or Scythe. There are mellow general discussions. Alright. Scythe and the Salvation option cures you of all rot. Alright, I think I like that. I don't want rot anymore, so let's get rid of it. Sorry for being so slow on that. Oh, what is this? And your soul is cleansed. Oh, that's really good. Well, I definitely don't want to do Call of the Worm now, so glad I didn't do that. Should I equip the Sailor's Lantern? Nope. Okay, wow, that was just, Spirit Stones popping up all over the place. Unless something really crazy happens, I will get this one. And then the only thing I have to do at that point is decide whether I want to, go here. And then I have to do one more quest after that. And then I can get into the castle, or whether I just want to break into the castle. I think I might as well just try to break in. The wits is this end and this end. I don't really have that much defensive gear, just this shield. The ranger's cloak is obviously completely worthless, so it'll be difficult for me to survive. Ideally, I'd want to break into the in during the day, because the guards move during the day, so if you break in at night, then the guards attack you after that. But if you break in during the day, then it's the Bane's turn, and the Banes don't go into the castle. So it's kind of a weird mechanic. You'd think it'd be better to, you know, break in during the night, typically when people want to break into places, but, that's just how the game works. Alright, I don't actually get to draw any cards. Three Banes to appear this night, okay. Doesn't actually really help me with what I'm trying to do. So yeah, it's not over yet. We're not on easy street here. The king, I mean, there's like 8 turns left. Oh, I have a bounty on my head. Fuck me. Well, this is actually kind of good. I get to burn some of these shitty cards before I draw. So let's see. I got one shield. He's going to throw in 5 dice. I wish I had some defensive cards here. Let's burn the longbow. It's just so bad. And I'm going to take a little chance here. We're going to burn this Call of Thorn. I definitely never want to cast it. Although, you know, that could help me break into the castle. A lot of them have rot symbols. Okay, he threw a miss. And I threw some missiles. So I'm only going to take 1 damage here. I didn't kill him. So the fact that I didn't kill him is kind of good, kind of bad. It means that I don't lose the prestige, but it also means that he's still around here. It's going to, you know, annoy me. Scar's fighting a Bane. Drives it back. Good job. Alright, try to get another item or a spell because I have magic that's being wasted. Let's try for a spell here. +1 to peril difficulty. That's the opposite of what I needed. It's a shitty symbol, and I don't want to increase the difficulty of perils right now. Should I step up to this guy? I don't think I want to do that. You know, I might as well put this thing on. This lets me see what the peril is. Maybe. Oh, I don't actually see what the symbols are. Steal 2 gold and give it to the poorest hero. Well, I'm the poorest hero, so it should give it back to me. I'm just gonna go here, camp out, so that Brun doesn't attack me. And I got an automatic match from Watch, so hooray! Hooray. +1 to peril difficulty. You know what? I'm just gonna get rid of this thing. I don't want that stupid thing. And Moon Juice! My magic's about to be reset, so it makes no sense to use Moon Juice. Okay, well, I think I'm committed. I'm gonna go over to this settlement. Or maybe not. Is Brun going in here? Ah, oh, goddammit. Hopefully it takes some damage. Wise vile official, -1 gold, so I don't really care about that. Alright, so he moved out, so I'm gonna steal the settlement from him at night, and then kinda take it from there. I mean, maybe I'll go grab my quest, or maybe I'll try to break in here. I do have the scout thing. The Sailor's Lantern, so I can see what this will be before going in it. Oh man, there's a Bane here. Oh man, well it's a good thing I lost all my rot, because if I hadn't, this thing would have an extra 3 dice against me. As it is, I have a guaranteed hit from Moon Juice. This thing is just a waste of a thing. It's holding up a spot in my hand. Poor Sana. Just getting it from all sides. I could go up through this one, actually. I could swoop back to this place and then go in there. Then I don't get the settlement prestige bonus, but I also don't have to fight a Bane right before breaking into the castle, which I'm not that jazzed about. Can the guard get 1 more hit on the Bane? It can. The Bane dies. Good job, guard. Good job. It would be nice to get some more income. I hate having to go through the swamp to get into the castle. I could, like, take over this settlement and then come up here. The guard will fight me because I still have a bounty. You know what? Let's just. Oh, river got routed. No place to retreat. Let's just fight this bane. It's five dice to five dice. I actually have an extra die because it is nighttime, and I can get two prestige if I kill it and then take over the settlement. Actually, this thing would get routed. It has no place to retreat. So all I have to do is deal more damage to it than it deals to me, and I'm good. Oh, there's another bane here. What the hell? All right. Well, let's take one of each, I guess. Plus one die. It's not the greatest. Hey, I can actually cast a lightning strike, but I can't kill the bane. The bane has four health. Let me think about this. Yeah, I can't kill either of these banes with it. I can't kill Brun with it. I can't kill anyone with a lightning strike, so I can cast a lightning strike, but unfortunately, it, doesn't allow me to, kill anyone. Is it worth fighting two banes this turn? That doesn't seem right at all. Alright, so here's what I'm gonna do. I'm going to just play this just to get rid of some cards. Let's just drink some moon juice here. Lightning strike. Oh, he's out of range, damn. Well. Sucks that I don't get to use lightning strike to good effect here. I won't be in range of Sana. Alright, we'll just lightning strike this bane. And then we'll go here, take over this settlement, and I'm gonna take the fight to the guard. He's gonna attack me at the beginning of the next round, so I might as well just do this. Sucks to lose a prestige, but I think it's worth it to get rid of him. And you know, it's cool and all to get plus one die in battle, but I'm just gonna burn this for the guaranteed hit, and then we'll also burn this thing just to get rid of it. It's a little risky taking that miss, but I feel like my odds are pretty decent of doing more damage to him than he deals to me. Oh, please don't get, he actually got two exploding dice in a row. Thankfully he got a shield, so that's good. So he's not gonna deal any damage to me. That's all I really cared about, is not taking damage. Oh shoot, I'm in a forest! Crap! That means I'm evading. That means if he attacks me, I'm gonna actually be driven back. But I am stealthed, so maybe he's not gonna see me there? I don't actually know how that works. Alright, Brun fights a bane. The bane meekly retreats. This guy's going all out. He's doing a pretty good job with the prestige. Ah, he doesn't deal any damage that time. Is he gonna come back in it? Oh, he is. Come on, bane. Do it. Ah, Brun couldn't get a hit again. Bane must have rolled some lucky-ass dice. Alright, so River, who died, is back here now. She's gonna get some spoils in the dungeon, and that should end her turn, unless she has some kind of haste effect. Okay, Sana's back here. Casts Dark Influence on River. That's a serious card. Gives him a Rot and a Plague card, although you generally want to cast that on yourself. I guess she's not pursuing a Rot victory. River actually got corrupted, jeez. That's pretty intense. A corrupted River might actually kill the king. Might actually have a chance at it with all those bonus dice. Although usually the problem is that they die. Prestige leader is given a bounty if they survive. Okay, so Ron has a bounty and he'll get some gold if no one kills him. Well, if I had saved that lightning strike, I guess I could have killed him now? Yeah, the guard didn't see me. Thank you, Forest Cloak. Appreciated. Much appreciated. Alright. If I go through this peril, I can make it into the castle. Of course, you know, I have to break the Wit's Peril in the castle. So I could build up a little more. I could go attack Sana. She would have a free shield for being in a mountain, though. Of course, then I'd have a shield for being in the mountain, and then I could move in the following time. No, I wanna get in right now. It's daytime. This is the time to go into the castle. I have no magic, so we're gonna go for items. Doom. All right, didn't get anything defensive, but the spyglass. Let's see. Let's get rid of the ranger's cloak. So I have plus two dice on scouted targets. I got the old combo here, scout plus two dice on scouted targets, and a bonus shield. I guess it's not the greatest, but it'll do, pig, it'll do. So let's go through this treacherous swamp. Oh, I should have scattered it first. Oh crap, if I had scattered it, I bet I would have gotten 2 bonus dice. Oh no, it gave me 2 dice anyway. Alright, I don't have my rot symbols, I don't have any shield symbols. Plus 1 rot and target is poisoned. Oh, brother. Oh no. That sucks. The poison is kind of annoying, because it means I'm going to actually lose a health stepping into the castle. Well, let's scout what's in here. Sword, shield, rot, wild. Man, it's actually not very good odds of making it, and then I lose a health stepping back into the swamp. Crikey. Alright, change of plans. What I'm going to do here is move to this place. It sucks to lose a health for being poisoned, but I think it's better to, you know, basically build up here. I need sword, shield, rot, wild, so try to get some cards and actually, you know, have a better shot at making through that peril. But definitely my odds of getting the quest way in is totally closed off. I passed on that horse, and I could be in trouble. If I can't make it through that peril, I'm gonna be in trouble. Wouldn't have minded the extra wit from this quest to be able to roll more dice. Man, Brun is just like attacking with every single turn. Christ. Alright, so he loses some prestige. I'm pretty much stuck at my prestige. But he's got a bounty on him. He might lose more prestige from guards attacking him as well. Alright, Sana hopefully won't attack me. She's not the attacking type. Oh, it's not even her turn. River finds a bane, so she's slowed down a little bit. Okay, so Sana, it's her turn for real this time. Yeah, she's not gonna fight me. She's too afraid. Don't take over my settlement, though. Thanks. Alright, if Sana breaks in for me, that'd be great. Wild, sword, shield, rot. I only have the sword, and I guess the wild gets matched, so I need sword, shield, and rot. There's another spirit stone. Great. Am I still poisoned? I still am, so I'm gonna be at 2 health if I break in this turn. That's not actually worth it. Yeah, because I dropped to 2 health walking in here, then I dropped to 1 health from frickin' rot. Minus 1 action point. Oh, it's the worst one. Alright. Play to forest. Ugh. Can't even play it anywhere. Well, I'll just put it here. Stick it between me and Brun. I am still poisoned. Man, that peril really was bad. I lost a lot of health to it. So if I move in here, I lose a health from the poison, and then I gain a health from being in the circle. Is it worth being here? Might as well see if there's like a story or something here. Should I walk in and out of it? That would cause me to lose more than I gain. That's not worth it. Should I put this thing on? Oh, I can't. I don't want to use this because I want to... Well, see, I'm only going to draw 1 card regardless, so I might as well just use this thing. So I get it out of my hand, and in case anyone attacks me. Alright, so I need a shield or a rot symbol. So items are more likely to give me shields. Spells are more likely to give me rot symbols, although spells also do have, spells also can get, shields. Brun walks through my peril. I don't want to fight him at all. Luckily, he didn't attack me. Yeah, alright, so next day, I'm going to have to just hope I get good die rolls. I do have 2 bonus dice. Oh, wait, why did I do that? I lowered my wits before doing a wits challenge. Whoops. That's definitely not right. But I don't want to wait another turn. Tricky. I mean, I could actually do like a weird change of plans. I could like go over here and try to get this quest and then bust in through the back. Do I have time for that? Let's see. Well, let's see if Sana can break this peril. Ah, so close, Sana. So close. You almost did it, girl. You almost did it. Now, Brun is going to ream you. All right, so it's day 7. Let's see. Day 7, night 7. I think it's worth it. I think it's worth it to do this, to get this extra wit to increase my odds of breaking through. I think I gotta do that. I think that if I were to try right now, my odds of success are just way too small, especially because I have to fight this guard to get in. Is he attacking Sana? I didn't realize Sana had a bounty on her. Oh, poor Sana. Oh, she loses an extra prestige from killing the guard. Oh, that's so sad. Really just too sad. Brun has a bounty on him, doesn't he? What? What? Brun's been, like, killing all the guards day in and day out. Oh, man, this is bad. This is bad. It's not looking good. At least, I'm just gonna burn these. I don't actually care about killing this guard, but I definitely don't want those. I want defensive items, not offensive ones. Going for Spirit Stone. Oh my god, that was a lot of re-rolled dice. Can I get some shields off of that? Well, the guard didn't actually roll any hits, so it doesn't matter. Oh boy, that guard. That guard really got taken. Unfortunately, I lose a prestige for my shenanigans here. I think this is the way to do it. Yeah, we're gonna walk around this way, try to get that quest, and I'm gonna actually go for items, hoping for a healing item, honestly. This thing. Well, I'm already rotted, so I might as well. Yeah, better than just a regular shield. I don't wanna fight, oh, hang on a second. The Bane is gonna have two bonus dice against me, though. What are my odds of actually killing it? You know what, screw it. Screw it. We're going in. Let's just see what the hell happens. If I die, chances are Brun will kill me, and then I'll have to just try to walk back in there. Alright, so I get a match, get a bunch of bonus dice. I roll a sword onto my match, which means these swords are useless. Alright, it's gonna take a pretty good roll to get this. Oh, that was almost a worm. Oh, man, oh, man. Alright, so I'm actually kind of hoping Brun kills me. See, oh, I'm not wearing that thing that gives me stealth anymore. Yeah, right, I'm hoping he kills me so I can go back to the beginning and basically be at full health. And then I just charge back into the castle. Alright, so I get a couple of bonus dice from the spyglass and some bonus stuff. What I'm hoping for here is a suicide. I don't want these offensive items. So I'm hoping for a suicide situation here. And I roll, of course, a bunch of shields. He kills me, but I don't kill him. That's just... these shields that he rolled suck. I didn't kill him. I just tickled him. Alright, so I'm definitely gonna lose on prestige if I don't successfully break into the castle and make it to the end of the game. That's not great. And, let's see. So what happens is I walk up to the stone circle on my next turn. And that sucks, I have to go through a swamp. Actually, I could walk like this. I could go through the dungeon if River's not here, and then I could walk in this way. Then I don't take an extra damage. Yeah, going through the circle doesn't give me anything. Oh, it does. I'm gonna lose a health at dawn from being rotted again. Actually, if I hadn't lost that three rot, I would have been corrupt. But let's see. I can heal one and then take a damage, or I can get treasure and not take damage. I mean, if I get like a teleport here, it'd be nice. I could actually get that quest maybe. If I get gold, that could be nice as well. Maybe actually use up an extra item. All right, so I'm gonna be breaking in during the day, which is good, but I might lose this game because I am gonna lose on the prestige if I don't kill the king in time, or if somebody kills the king and suicides, Brun will take it. So I have to get in there. This isn't one where I can just sit back and win it. Yeah, I think going through here makes the most sense, as opposed to risking this thing. This way there's like two places people could block me, where if I go here there's only one place I can get blocked. Of course the Bane will attack me if I'm there in that circle. I probably have to take that into consideration. Plus one action point. Alright, this is a really good item. It means that if you break into the castle you can actually chug this and then get another turn. So that's a good find. That's worthless. Plus two fight and minus one wits until the end of my next turn. I don't want to do that because I need those wits. Plus two health per turn for the next three turns. Alright, that's good. So this is what I want. Gain some health. And you know what? I probably don't want that Bane to fight me. It's only got one attack or one health though, but it's going to be rolling seven dice. Damn. Wait. It's about to be day. The Banes have already taken their turn. Right, so I just need to go to this circle. This actually does not cure the rot damage that I take, but hopefully my spell does. I guess it depends on the order that things resolve. Should I put that shield on? So what's better, two extra dice or a shield? I think the dice are better, because the dice help me beat this peril, which is really significant. Alright, Brun gets even more prestige. I gotta admit, this Brun guy's doing a pretty good job. Just wandering around and marauding everybody. Ah, he has died, however. Killing River in the process. Sana's watching like, oh, what's happening, guys? Alright, so in the day, I will walk into the castle. I will have 4, 5, 6 dice. I'll need to match 3 symbols. I believe there was a worm symbol here. I can't friggin' remember. There was definitely a shield. There's definitely a shield involved. I don't think there was any suns. There's a wild symbol that I get matched automatically for my amulet choice. Sana, no! Oh god, please get pushed back. Oh, of course she makes it. Oh my fucking Christ. So now I have to push her away. I have to do more damage to her than she deals to me, so I can push her away. And then, of course, as long as I have at least 1 health left, I can drink this hot rot wine. No, I don't want -1 body to all heroes. Oh god, this isn't good. All right, so wait. I do have regeneration, don't I? +2 health per turn. Yes. So it sucks that I lost the body. Okay, what needs to happen here is Sana needs to hold her ground, because I have a better chance of beating her than beating a guard, I think. Okay, that was, you didn't even try, Sana. I guess I don't. I mean, they only have 4 fights. She has 3, plus I'm sure she has some items. Alright, Sana's continues to get wrecked. Okay, I need to take no more than 3 damage. No, 2 damage, because I have to walk through a swamp from that guy. Okay, what do I need? Well, I don't have any things. I need to hope for a healing card. +2 magic. Well, I don't need wits anymore, so I do want to cast Feral. Therefore, let's drink the moon juice, I suppose. Get some ferocity going here. And think very carefully about this fight. So I'm going to have 3 health going into it. I cannot take 2 damage from this guy. I can get a shield, but if I get a shield, I have to lose 2 dice. So what's better, 1 guaranteed shield or 2 dice? Because all I really care about are shields. I'm sure I'm going to get enough hits with my die rolls. So, yeah, because I've got this 7 fight. So, actually, I think a shield is worth more than 2 dice. Yeah, 2 dice are worth, on average, 1/3 of a shield. So I can use this and still drink the wine. I have enough gold. So, yeah, we will get rid of Spyglass. So I have 2 shields guaranteed. I cannot take more than 1 damage. If I take 2, I can't drink the wine. So let's enter. I need to not take damage from this guard. So if he rolls a bunch of, you know, wilds, then I'm totally screwed. But hopefully these 2 shields will hold the fort here. Okay, I've got another shield. 3 shields. So he has to deal at least 5 damage to me. Oh, he threw a bunch of misses. Man, if those had all been exploding suns, I would have been totally fucked. So we're illustrating here an important trick in this game. Hot rot wine is a very important item, perhaps more important than the designers ever really intended. Because what it allows you to do is, after you break into the castle and lose all your action points, you can chug the wine to lose a health and get 1 more action point, and then you can wander in and say, King, I banish thee! And then the king dies. Would I have had a chance of killing him and living? Honestly, probably not. So it's a good thing that happened. Well, thanks for watching, everybody. Hope you enjoyed that. Please like and or subscribe. And I'll see you again soon with some more Armello. A journey of decadence. Oh yes, I unlocked the next thing, which gives a gold whenever you win in battle. As a wolf. Goodbye!